Well, there are actually, there are over 300 conventions in the United States this year in 103 different locations, of which Johnstown is one of those 103 locations.
We had one here in 1962. I was 8 years old at the time. Well, it's been very successful this year, and so that's a good indicator that that might be the case, and we're very pleased to have it here. It's a very friendly town, and everybody's been very cooperative with the efforts. It's very nice to have it locally where we can invite our neighbors to come and enjoy the event as well.
Well, each of us, we can volunteer for certain departments, and based upon our, you know, the ability that we have to help in those particular areas, we're able to do that. And, you know, so there's various departments that help for the convention to run smoothly, anywhere from the cleaning department to attendance and helping individuals through the weekend. So there's, you know, various opportunity, and all through the weekend, individuals volunteer in certain areas to just keep the facility clean, assist the other brothers and sisters in any way they possibly can. There were quite a few people here. Well, I know that there were a little over 1,200 that actually signed in, but there were others that were already here from everywhere, from is north of Pittsburgh, Butler, Shakora, individuals from Hagerstown, Maryland, Cumberland, parts of West Virginia. So anyone that's involved with any of the four conventions here in Cleveland had the ability to grab their buckets and their rags and come up for a day of cleaning, and it was quite an event, really. There was a lot of joy. And we, you know, really had the opportunity to take advantage of what the facility was able to give us. They welcomed us with open arms, and you know, it's a great facility. It's a great venue for the conventions, and we just had a real nice time in doing that. And we appreciated the fact that we were able to do it.
Many of the people came here and did what they do for a living: floor cleaning, construction, electrical, and others that don't have those particular construction trades. They just came and helped clean floors, wipe seats. All of us did something to help in the effort. Well, an individual begins studying the Bible. They come to have a basic understanding of what Bible standards are, what Jehovah God expects Christians to live like, moral principles that they practice in their lives, basic Bible laws that we need to live by, which basically makes us better citizens, better people. And once an individual comes to a basic understanding and they begin applying that information in their lives, that they are living a Christian life, then they would qualify to dedicate their life to serve Jehovah God. And that's basically what the baptism is. It's a public symbol of the fact that they have dedicated their life to serve their God Jehovah. And this is the beginning for them of that service.
I just feel like I was reborn. After a couple of Bible studies, I was convinced that this is the truth, and I want it. Well, they're just brothers and sisters. It's like one big family, and everyone has the same belief, and everyone has the same characters and values, and they all believe that we have the true religion because we don't teach violence, and we go by the scriptures, always by the scriptures, because it's God's written word.
And a lot of people are not familiar with what's taking place, so being that it is closer, they are more receptive to the opportunity to come. Because everyone here provides their living for themselves. Nobody here is paid for doing anything. All the ministering is completely volunteer. As Jesus said, you receive free, give free.